What's going on, DJBooth.net? This is DJ Blaze, aka Kareem Julian, and I'm here in the lab to give you guys a quick rundown video of a DIY project that I have been working on recently. So recently I was thinking to myself, after using the Traktor Z2 mixer and the Pioneer DJM T1 mixer, that you know, the new mixers of today's age is going to allow you to plug your software directly into your mixer. That way, you only have to plug your turntables, your vinyl decks, or your CD decks directly into the mixer inputs, and you don't need an external box. So since I use Traktor mostly, I had an extra Audio 4 box and an extra Audio 6 box laying around. And what I ended up doing was installing the Audio 4 sound card inside of the Korg KM-202 mixer that I have, and then I installed the Traktor Audio 6 into the Vestax PMC-05proIV that we have. And the process, I wanted to make it so it was completely reversible. I can always take out my audio sound cards at any time and use them with any other mixer. I also wanted to make sure that the DVS output was going to be good, and that nothing shakes or rattles around inside, and that it would work just as good as another mixer that had inputs already built into it that are made for digital vinyl signal playback, for timecode playback. So basically what I did was I installed these Traktor boxes. I'm going to give you a better in-depth look in a second so you can see exactly what's going on, and I'll actually show you guys how it works within the Traktor system. But basically what I did was I grabbed the Traktor box. Most people don't know this, but mixers are almost like 80% empty, so there's a lot of space in most of your mixers. You can just remove your top panel, which contains all of your faders and everything on them. Most mixers are the same. The Rains are the same. The Vestax are the same. The Stantons. So most mixers have a basic normal layout where you can remove your top panel and there's a whole lot of space underneath and inside that you can use. So basically I took the box, transplanted it inside. I got some red and white couplers where I was able to couple the red and white RCA connection from the outside to the inside. And on the inside of these mixers, there's basically RCA cables connected to these couplers that go to the inputs. And then for the outputs, we end up drilling a small hole so that we can bring the RCA leads directly out and plug it into an input on your mixer. That way, all you have to do now is plug in your USB dongle to power your audio sound card from Traktor. And then you just plug in your RCAs directly into your new Traktor inputs. Second input over here, first input over here. These are the gold connectors. These are the Traktor leads. You plug in your two decks and you're ready to go. So I'll show you a quick deeper look so you guys can see exactly how it all goes down. Okay, just to give you guys a quicker sneak peek at the rear of the unit so I can tell you what I was talking about. This is the PMC-05proIV. And as you can see, we have a new USB port here on the side. This is the USB port that powers and sends data from the Traktor audio interface. You have your new RCA ports. On the back of this, there's RCA cables that plug right into the coupler that go directly into the Traktor sound card inputs. And your outputs are coming, our RCA cables coming directly out of the sound card and back into your inputs of your mixer. And this is where you're getting your Traktor signal for deck A and deck B. So all you gotta do is plug in a USB cable here. I've gotta plug in another USB cable here because we have mini buttons. So I'll have two USB cables sticking out of this unit, but still it's way more compact when you have it all in the mixer. And then you plug in your decks with time code control and you're pretty much ready to go. Same over here on the Korg. The Korg KM-202. We have your USB dongle here. We have your two Traktor decks, Traktor B, Traktor A, and then you have your A and your B going directly into the line inputs. Okay, so here you see we have the mixer with a lot of Traktor logos on it, and basically all we have to do is you have Traktor on the screen. Right now you can see there's no sound card plugged in, as this is ratted out. As soon as we grab the USB and make the connection,
this sound card on the screen should go green on its own. Went green. So there you have it. You have connectivity with your audio 4. So next up, I'll give us an output so you guys can hear that it's working. Next up is the input from the timecode record deck. We'll plug that into B. Deck B is on this side. Red on the bottom and white on the top. And then we plug in our mixer's power. Once we have that in, we'll turn on the mixer. Mixer is on. We'll get a track ready. Again, there's no MIDI buttons on the Korg, so you will have to use your keyboard for things like that. But say if you have a favorite mixer and you really want to bring it into the new age, then this might be one of the things you check out to do. So we'll grab a track, we'll throw it up there. Oops, supposed to throw it up into deck B, which is time code controlled. And we'll see if we got action over here. So there you have it. And because the way that we did this, all of the effects on the KM-202 still work as well. So, pretty cool feature. So there you guys have it. This is the DIY for your Traktor install right into your mixer. Same thing over here on the Vestax. It's not all hooked up, but works exactly the same way. There's an audio 6 in the 05Pro 4, and then there's an audio 4 in the Korg KM-202. Basically, they both work the same. If you want to undertake this project, I know that you can fit this box inside of many different mixers. Let me just show you guys what it looks like inside really quick. I'll turn this off. Let you guys get a quick sneak peek so you can see how it's all ran. As you can see, we have the full Traktor box inside. You have your coils cabled up and leading to the inputs. And then over here, you have your, let's see if I can get a shot of this. You have your audio 4, your audio 4 inputs here. It's basically just couplers. So just standard RCAs. You get the couplers. They got a guy on eBay that has RCA couplers. That's where I got these from. You get your angled hosa cables. They got them everywhere. And you're basically ready to go. Oh, and you also need your USB, which is down here, your USB port, which is internal. That's about 10 bucks. So all together for about 30, 35 bucks, depending on the quality cables and components you use, that's all it's going to cost you to turn your favorite mixer into a mixer that can actually accept DVS directly into it. So you can also do this same mod for your Rain TTM56. There's plenty of room in there. There's plenty of room in all the Vestax mixers except for maybe the PMC-08. You got to make sure you have enough room on the rear panel to do the drilling. And you got to get a good spacing and make sure it all fits. Like, this was a very tight fit on the Vestax. Not so much on the Korg. There's a lot of mixers you can do this to, though. Just basically study the rear of the mixer and the height of everything. And you also may have to move around some boards. You may have to disassemble your audio card up to a certain extent. But it's the price to pay if you really want to make your mixer Traktor ready or Serato ready. You can also do this with the SL1, the SL2. Anything that is USB powered, which is a DJ sound card, you can do this with. So So for more on DJ equipment, DIYs, reviews, and videos, just head on over to our main website, which is www.djboot.net/DJS. You can also check me out on Twitter. That way you would have probably known about this a little bit earlier than the rest of the folks watching the video now. But the Twitter handle is @DJBlaze_DJBooth. And keep subscribing to the YouTube channel. That way you know when all these cool videos are coming out next. And you'll see a few other mods that I'm also planning in the works and we're currently about to do in a few days. So subscribe. Thanks for watching.